Hi folks, today we're out in the field shooting large format. The location we have is the RC sewage treatment plant, one of Toronto's, one of the iconic buildings in Toronto in the Art Deco style. Pretty unusual building for a water treatment plant, but quite interesting in the details it has. If you get a chance to visit inside, it's pretty outstanding as well too. But today we're outside. And our composition is the main building down here. It's a pretty long building, and today we'll be shooting with our Horseman FA. It's a full metal technical camera, and I'll show you how I have set up so far. So this one's the Horseman FA. A fully metal camera anyways. I mean, it's still 4x5, but today I have it set up with the 90mm lens. Normally the standard lens would be like a 150, but seeing that the building is quite long and has a character, you know, we want to capture that as well too. So I'm going with a bit of a wide angle lens, so we're going with the 90. Fully manual lens, of course. And on the back of the camera, you will see it even has a little mini viewing hood. I'll see if I can take you inside. So that's just the basic composition so far anyways. I've just squared up the camera. I haven't done anything, no rise and falls or anything like that. And you'll notice it's pretty much dead center. So composition wise, not the best, but I like the way the leading line goes into, you know, the left-hand side. Yes, the image is upside down, but it's also backwards. That's the way the image is projected onto the ground glass as you see it. So as it stands, you know, there's not a whole lot going on the ground part, so I do want to raise the image up. To do that, I'm going to use the rise feature on the lens. So this is going to raise the lens up. So let's see what that looks like. So by raising the lens up, I'm actually lowering the image onto the ground. So I'm less ground, more sky. So I've got the main building about a 1/3, you know, following the rule of thirds. So far so good, right? Well, we do have an issue though. Seeing that the building is so long, all the way into, you know, pretty much filling the whole frame, we have a depth of field issue. We have to decide, well, how are we going to shoot this? We could stop down to, you know, F22, F32, F64 or so, but then we, you know, at the mercy of a lens aberration and so forth. But there is an easier way to manage this as well too. Whatever exposure, I'm going to shoot roughly this one, you know, some nice light, maybe about F11, but that's still not going to give me the whole depth of field on the scene yet. So what we're going to do, we're actually going to swing the back of the lens and also the front of the lens as well too. Remember Scheinflug principle? Well, without closing down the aperture too much, we can actually get the full length of this building in focus, nice and sharp, without having to stop down so much. So let's give that a try. So what have I done so far? Well, if you look from above, I've angled the lens ever so slightly to match the angle of the subject plane. And I've also brought out the rear frame slightly ever so much. And I'm going to double check that, see how much of the area I have in focus so far. So I've put on my dark glass. And I have a loop, so I'm going to do some critical checking of all, make sure that everything I want is in focus as much as possible. Then, right now, I'm focusing at wide open right now. I'm also going to stop down to probably go F8, F11, and then double check again, make sure that the whole area that I want in focus is in focus as well too. Oh, made a few minor adjustments just to make sure that the whole film plane was in focus that I wanted to be. So left side is in focus, the right side is in focus. So I've got the whole area in focus right now. And it's slightly off, but I think that's about to be brought down by shutting down the aperture. So right now I'm shooting wide open. I need to figure out my next thing, I need to figure out my exposure. So next thing we need to do is take a meter reading. We do need a light meter because everything's manual on this camera. Now we have several ways of metering this scene. We can do it, if the light that's shining on you is the same as the building, it's pretty much, it is. I'm in shadow, most of the building in shadow except the part that's kissing the top. I take the meter reading as it is from here. Or I can do a spot metering if there's a big variance of light from what's falling on me to the subject area. But in this case, the incident meeting will be fine. I'm gonna set my ISO to 100 because that's what the film I'm shooting at. And I'm going to start off at F8 and see what kind of meter reading I get. And I'm getting a meter reading an eighth of a second so far. There's not a whole lot moving. If I go down to F11, that changes to a fourth of a second. So I'm gonna shoot at F8. The shutter speed will be eighth of a second. So I'm gonna set that on the camera. So on the front of the camera, on the lens itself, I've set the aperture at F8 and the shutter speed at eighth of a second. I do need to attach a cable release. Other than that, I'm set to go. I can do a test exposure. Cock the shutter. And everything seems to be working so far. So good. So I can remove this and I'll get the film holders ready. Okay, after having all done all that, well, what have we done so far? Well, we've got a location. We found our subject. We set up our camera. We've done our composition on the back of the ground glass. We've adjusted that composition, made sure that all the elements that we want in focus are in focus. We took the meter reading for the exposure. We've set that on the lens itself. And now we're ready to make our first exposure. So remember the film that we had prepared before? Well, this is the film holder with two shots ready to go. Making sure that this side is not being used. So white indicating unexposed. Gonna drop that in to the camera with that side facing out towards the lens, slides in, going to cock the shutter, have our cable release ready to go. I'm going to remove the dark slide that's nearest to the lens and make our exposure. We just made our first exposure on that scene. I'm going to take our dark slide, make sure the black part is facing out and flip it around, indicating that now that side is exposed so I don't accidentally double expose that. And that, my friends, is one exposure on a 4x5. And from this point on, we can move on to our next location.